Welcome back, guys. Now it's time to introduce TestNG XML. We already have created two test cases, so in order to run the two test cases together, we need a TestNG XML, and we can run those two test cases together. Let me show you how. So I am closing all these windows, all these open programs, and I will just open the TestNG XML to show it to you. This is my TestNG XML. In case you have to convert your project to a TestNG project, you just right click on the project and go to TestNG and say convert to TestNG. I did that, and TestNG created this test file for me, TestNG XML file for me, and I got it ready made. So I just made a few changes. Initially this class name was inside the test, this first test tag, but I have created another test tag with name as test1, and I have put the class name, the second test, over here. The basic test will be run first and the second test will be run after the basic test. Moreover, I have done a small change to one of the classes. Let me show you what change I have done. The change that I have done is to the homepage.java. Initially the click logout method, as is shown on line 46 over here, was a non-static method. That means you have to create an object of homepage and only then could you access this click logout method. But now I have made it static, so you can access it anytime using the class dot method name. As you all might be aware that we can access static methods in a class using the class name dot method name. No need to create object of that class in order to access that method. So here I have click logout method, and I have introduced a small thread.sleep. This is not a good practice, but it's just for the time being that I have introduced a thread.sleep of 5000 milliseconds. And before clicking the welcome link, this is basically for the logout. So if you notice on the home page, we have a welcome link. Once the user logs in, he gets a welcome link on the right hand top corner, and then it clicks this welcome link. After that, it waits for another 5000 milliseconds and then it clicks the logout link. So this is the small change that I have done. Instead of closing the browser, I am just logging it out, logging out the session, and I am logging in again for the next test case. So for any test case, for any test suite to function properly, after each test execution, after each test tag completes, you have to have the system in the same state as it was before the test execution began. Alright, let's run our test suite and let's see whether we get our desired results. So right click on testng.xml, say run as testng suite. It will start executing the test one after another. There you go. The first test is running. The system is a little slow, so you might expect this on your system, and better to connect it with a LAN, as I already have said in my previous sessions. Alright, there you go. It enters the username password. It now is on the home page. So if you notice this welcome admin link right over here is the link that I was mentioning. So it is now rendering the page, then it will click on the user management link and then on the users link. There you go, clicks on the users link, it clicks on the add button now. Yes, opening the page. It is a little slow, so bear with me. Alright, there you go. It takes the first username, clicks on save, clicks on add, second username, clicks on save, third username, and now it is clicking, it will click on save again. There you go, third username, clicked on save. There, now it completes the first test case. Now it will click on welcome admin. There you go, it clicks on login, logout. Yes, logs in again, rendering the page. Now it clicks on user management, users again. It searches for the first username, search. It clicks the, it changes the password, clicks on save. Second username, yes, clicks the save button again, and then it clicks on the third username. There you go. All right, so now our test has completed. Let's wait for it to click on the welcome admin button. Okay, yes, clicks on the welcome admin button. After 5 seconds it will click on the logout. There you go. And the test has completed successfully. If you had noticed, there was a green patch over here, so that indicates the test has completed successfully, and we have completed executing 2 test cases successfully with a singleton driver and with the testng XML. Now in the next session I will probably cover extent reports. I have introduced the testng XML to you, and so it is high time we look into reporting. Thank you so much for watching this video.